and I don't believe that I'm a woman. I am a woman. Even my birth certificate has been changed to Jessica, I was born a female. I was born in Brazil, so I do have a Brazilian passport, but also have a British passport.
Welcome back, welcome back. Let's just get straight into this, okay? I want to welcome everyone back, all the subscribers and everyone watching. Let's get into this one from Sky News. So JK Rowling, right? To me, she is literally a beacon of hope for normality, a beacon of hope for women's rights, and a beacon of hope for everything. I mean, yes, she brought us Harry Potter, and look, we all grew up with those movies. I guess a lot of people did anyway, depending what age you are, but, you know, great movies. And it was pretty much like whole family fun, right? It was started off with kids movies and worked its way up. And the book she writes, she writes so well. Now, this brings me to this, where she has now had to become a fighter for women's rights because no one else is standing up for them. Everyone else is just saying, no, 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 it's okay. It's okay. Let's just not worry about women's rights when it comes to these trans women, right? So let's have a look what she said. She obviously posts constantly. I mean, constantly she's posting things like this. For example, she points out people who write stupid things. So she writes, good work, cult member number 28749. Your laughter has caused the cow's milk to dry up, the crops to wither, and frail men to quail before you. Catch you at midnight for a debrief, and please bring your own toad and broomstick. Sorry to nag, but I don't have an inexhaustible supply. So this is from India, some obviously crazy wokey lady, who says, seen this police, Scotland? This is what happens when you say trans people are fair game. Stuff your free speech. And this is now a thing that is under attack in Scotland at the moment, where they are passing laws to kind of knuckle back your freedom of speech over there. So, you know, hate speech, anything like that, anything that they deem is hate speech, you will be arrested. You will go to jail. This is what happened in Spain. Someone said something mean online to a trans person, and they are in jail for 6 months. All right, now let's get into this one here. JK Rowling, she said, and I mean, this is, who does this when you're a billionaire, you're someone who can retire lovely, you don't even need to worry about any of these squabbles. She came out and said, if they go after any woman for simply calling a man, I'll repeat that woman's words and they can charge us both. And this is now what I'm talking about with this new law now, these new freedom of speech laws, that if you say something bad to a trans person or whatever, then you're facing jail time. So she's saying she'll put her neck on the line for him, which is freaking so cool. I mean, she has earned my respect so much and probably 10 times over. Everyone has asked her, obviously, what she means, you know, what a woman is, all that type of stuff. So I'll quickly read a little bit of it for you. So, I believe a woman is a human being who belongs to the sex class that produces large gametes. It's irrelevant whether or not her gametes have been fertilized, whether or not she's carried a baby to term, irrelevant if she was born with a rare difference of sexual development that makes neither of the above possible. If she's aged beyond being able to produce viable eggs, she is a woman and just as much a woman as the others. I do not believe a woman is more or less of a woman for having sex with men, woman, both. So she's just pretty much saying she doesn't care how you dress, you know, what other sex you like, whatever it is. She doesn't care if you're gay, whatever. All she cares about is what a woman is a woman. Womanhood isn't a mystical state of being, nor is it measured by how well one apes sex stereotypes. We are not the creatures either porn or the Bible tell you we are. Femaleness is not, as trans woman Andrea Chu Long wrote, an open mouth, an expectant asshole, blank, blank eyes. Nor are we God's afterthought sprung from Adam's rib. Women are probably subject to certain experiences because of our female bodies, including different forms of oppression, depending on the cultures in which we live. When the trans activists say, I thought you didn't want to be defined by your biology, it's a feeble and transparent attempt at linguistic sleight of hand. Women don't want to be limited, exploited, punished, or subject to other unjust treatment because of their biology. Now, she just kind of goes on about that as well, about the sex classes, etc. Some people feel strongly that they should have been or wish to be as the sex class in which they weren't born. Gender dysphoria is a real and very painful condition, and I feel nothing but sympathy for anyone who suffers from it. I want them to be free to dress and present themselves however they like, and I want them to have exactly the same rights as every other citizen regarding housing, employment, and personal safety. I do not, however, believe that surgeries and cross-sex hormones literally turn a person into the opposite sex. Nor do I believe in the idea that each of us has a nebulous gender identity. That may or might not match our sexed bodies. I believe the ideology that preaches those tenets has caused and continues to cause very real harm to vulnerable people. 100% agree with her on that. I am strongly against women's and girls' rights and protections being dismantled to accommodate trans-identified men for the very simple reason that no study has ever demonstrated that trans-identified men don't have exactly the same pattern of criminality as other men, and because however they identify, men retain their advantage of speed and strength. In other words, I think the safety and rights of girl and woman are more important than those of men's desires for validation. Literally, bravo. Bravo. Yep, you can tell she is a really good writer. So just the way she writes it all describes it. I sincerely hope that answers your questions. You may still disagree, but as I hope this shows, I am more than happy to have this debate. Now, the thing that I think she should also say is that she should also be against, you know, men's rights and protections being dismantled to accommodate trans-identified women. So I believe it should be the same way around, because as a man, we don't want a woman in our changing rooms either. So I think it could be both. Now, this is the greatest comment I've seen is Jennifer says, have you considered pursuing writing? You are skilled. Good little bit of comedy there. Now, it brings me to this last one here, where this person just looks as you would think they are. Let's have a listen here. So this is a trans influencer calling out JK Rowling, calling her words hurtful, and saying she should stick to what she knows. She's a woman, and so I'm also a woman. I'm a transgender woman. She's a biological woman, but we are both women, she says. Let's have a listen to this woman.
I am a woman. Even my birth certificate has been changed to Jessica was born.
I don't know what that thing is. Seriously, that is, could be a fish. This could be a lot of things. Those lips are ridiculous. The whole face is ridiculous. Yeah. If this person literally is married or something, I will be very, very, very surprised. What is this freaking trans influencer called? Seriously, because I want to search this person up. Nana speaks of TV personality Jessica Alves. Let's have a look. Jessica Alves relationship. Surely not. Surely. Oh my gosh. I guess anyone would do anything to get with someone who's famous, right? It's pretty... Ah, let's have a look. She reveals pressure. I'm afraid to say at home alone. Jessica Alves reveals pressure to find a relationship and have kids ahead of turning 40. It's causing her severe anxiety. Her? How is he gonna have kids? That's what I wonder. Yeah, no. That, you can't have kids. You can adopt a kid. Yes. Go ahead and adopt a kid. There's a lot of kids that want to be adopted, so do that rather, but I'd feel sorry for that kid.
Female. I was born in Brazil, so I do have a Brazilian passport, but also have a British passport. And my both passports also stated Jessica Alves, female. And I am a woman. In my mind, in my soul, in my appearance, in my body, in the touch of my skin. When I wake up in the morning and I look myself in the mirror to brush my teeth like everybody, I see the image of a woman.
You do not look like a woman. You look freaking like a plastic face. That's all you look like. You don't look like you have any emotions. You actually look like a horror creature, if I gotta be honest. Imagine if you're walking in the middle of the night and you see this dressed up in pink with this blonde hair and that face like this. You would be afraid. I would be afraid. I would start running. I'm getting out of here. And yeah, for that article to keep saying she right? This is what the article said, wants to have a kid. You can't. You don't have ovaries. You cannot have a child. That is just impossible. Biologically talking. So how about that, YouTube? Try and take this video down, buddy. But anyway, I'm going to end it on that because I'm not going to give this person another minute of the day because that's just ridiculous. That, and apparently they're an influencer. And this is why the next generation and the next generation is getting more and more messed up in the head. It's because these are freaking people they look up to. Do you know what the number one role model is for young girls this day and age? Freaking Kim Kardashian. Right? A person who can't hold a relationship, a person who has been impregnated by a few different people, someone who just talks openly about having kids with someone because they're a good athlete, and then also someone who doesn't spend time with their kids and, you know, wants to put their kids on Balenciaga, where they literally, you know, was literally borderline into sexual things. And you want to tell me that is someone they look up to? And let's not forget the only reason why she became famous because of her sex tape. That is the only reason why she became famous. And that is who girls look up to. Very, very sad. And you wonder why the next generations are kind of tearing apart and tearing apart. But anyway, I'll end up with that. Let me know what you think. I mean, what, first of all, what do you think about Kim Kardashian being the number one role model for young girls? What do you also think about J.K. Rowling standing up for these women's rights and saying, look, if you're going to punish someone else, you've got to punish me too? That is who should be young girls' role models, right? J.K. Rowling. That is insane. And yet again, I also think that she should also stand up for men as well at the same time, because we don't want women in our freaking changing rooms. If I ever seen that as well, I'll be just as disgusted. But anyway, I'll end it on that. Let me know what you think. Like the video if you like it. And subscribe as well. It's the best way to support the channel. Thank you for watching.